When would Jack join us? The president will join you in the Monroe room at the end of the tour. You'll be great. They want to hear from you.
Excuse me.
For the next hour, Mrs. John F. Kennedy invites you to visit the president's house and see some of the restorations she's made in its interior.
The White House tour is probably the most watched television show of all time at that point.
I want to thank you for letting us visit your home. I don't think any television cameras have ever gone up there.
That's right.
Pablo was very enamored of it and thought it was a really interesting window into who she was before the assassination.
Are all the pieces from Lincoln's time?
Yes, they are. The most famous one, of course, is the Lincoln bed.
She would explain what happened to Lincoln's wife after Lincoln was assassinated.
Lincoln's widow died destitute, had to sell all of her furniture.
And she will face the same fate 2 years after.
If I sell some of it back now, maybe I can put John and Caroline through school.
I was like, look, it's the same story. We have to use this.
Action.
Pablo did a phenomenal job in recreating the White House tour.
They built the White House in Paris. I mean, it was really crazy.
It's seamless when you watch the old footage versus the new footage.
Shot by shot, it's a replica. We don't even change a single word.
This piano was designed by Franklin Roosevelt with the Eagle support.
The framing, to the way that Jackie speaks, to the costumes, to every sort of element.
Here's what the White House did to President Lincoln, the strong man with the arched eyebrow. The camera work, I think, was really incredible, the way that they were able to match the original.
This is the East Room, as Americans have known it now for 60 years.
That's right.
Pablo used real footage, I mean, the actual interview. From distances, it's Jackie, and other times, it's Natalie.
You cannot really know which one is the original footage and which one is our footage. You have this grainy cinematography in black and white. The cameras they used back then, they have a technology with tubes, and we used that to capture it, this old video format. It's just exactly how it was made.
What happens when the next president's wife comes into the White House?
In the past, you see, they could sell it or throw it out.
I think it was a great element to have in the film.
What do you think of the changes that she made?
It allows you to see Jackie before all this tragedy.
Well, I think the great effort that she's made has been to bring us much more intimately in contact with all the people who were legendary, but who actually were alive and were in these rooms.
Hey, Vale here. Like me, are you a movie lover? Well, a list has been released of the top 100 films of the 21st century, and we have cut it down to give you the top 10 films as selected by 177 film critics from around the world. At number 10, No Country for Old Men by Joel and Ethan Coen from 2007. At number 9, A Separation by Asghar Farahadi from 2011. Number 8, Yi Yi, A 1 and a 2 by Edward Yang from 2000. Number 7, The Tree of Life by Terrence Malick from 2011. Number 6, Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind by Michael Gondry from 2004. Number 5, Boyhood by Richard Linklater from 2014. Number 4, Spirited Away by Hayao Miyazaki from 2001. Number 3, There Will Be Blood by Paul Thomas Anderson from 2007. Number 2, In the Mood for Love by Wong Kar-wai from 2000. And number 1, Mulholland Drive by David Lynch from 2001. Do you agree with this list? How many of these films have you seen? Let us know in the comments below. And remember, if you haven't already done it, to subscribe to our channel for all the latest trailer releases. Bye-bye.